friends, join me in registering for the Health and Happy Study Series presented on the Bovie app. Let's get started. For Seventh-day Adventist members, click the link bovie.app/I will go. Be sure to enter your full name followed by an active email address. Then enter your telephone number starting with the area code. Choose a memorable password that is quick and easy. Then enter your address. And be sure to select how you heard about the app. Click Yes to confirm your membership and scroll down to select your respective organization. Finally, click Submit to complete your registration. Now you have access to the Health and Study Series and so much more.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Before he called us to duty, he led the way. And before he faced the mission, he'd fast and pray. Then he bade his disciples follow him. I'll make you fishers of men to save them from their sins. Jesus promised to be with me, empowered for the mission, inspired by whole. So with boldness we can fight the fight. As Jesus goes before us as our guiding light. Empowered for the mission. Jesus promised to be with me, empowered for the
Happy Sabbath, everyone. God is so good. To all our members and guests and all our students and faculty and staff from the SDA school, we say a special welcome to you. And to those of you viewing on Facebook and YouTube, we extend a special welcome to you as well. I am Marva Mercer, coming from the communication department with just a few announcements. To continue to pray for our sick and homebound members in your prayers, along with those who are off island seeking medical attention. Please add Sister Hermina Vanterpool to those individuals who are off island seeking medical attention. She left the island on Tuesday. And we also want to remember in a special way all our bereaved members. We continue to pray also for all the schools on our island. And our very own SDA school and faculty and staff, students, faculty, and staff. Next week, Sunday, which will be the 10th of December, we're gonna be out on the road again. The communications team will be out. We're gonna be distributing lunch to our homebound members, seniors, and homeless individuals, and anyone who just needs a hot meal. We always invite each and every one of you, if you're interested, to come along and join us. We have a few announcements from our school. The first one is this Sunday, December 3rd, we will have work at the SDA school. They're building a retaining wall around the agricultural area, and they're asking for volunteers. So anyone who may have some time and willing to come out and help, the work begins at 8 o'clock, and they're thanking you in advance for your services. They also have a school calendar that they're producing for 2024. And right now, currently, they're accepting ads to be placed in it. So if you're interested in placing for an ad, please contact the school at 340-775-3525. We also have another announcement from this is from our senior class. They have a little unique fundraiser. It's a gingerbread house building contest. Any of y'all know how to make a gingerbread house? Well, you can come out on December 10th. That's next Sunday at 5 o'clock p.m. at the school. And if you're interested, you could please contact any member of the senior class. Can the members of the senior class please stand so the members can see who you are? You can contact any of these individuals. And they would give you all further information, okay? So that's next week, Sunday at 10, at the 10th at 5 p.m. Okay. How many of you know what youth car is? This is a new announcement that came out this week. And youth car stands for Youth United Through Christ, Aiming Heavenward. And they are going to have a mega senior youth fellowship event, which is going to be hosted by the Senior Youth of the Caribbean Union Conference of Seventh-day Adventists. And right now until February 28, 2024 is the registration date. This big event is going to take place on the island of Trinidad at the University of Southern Caribbean. And it's going to be on July 11th to the 21st, 2024. If you want more information, you can please contact your Advent Youth Area Coordinators. We have some more information about that. I think there's a video, and we'll be doing more announcements about that next week. So stay tuned for that. We're gonna have a big evangelical crusade coming up, which is going to be next year, February 17th to the 23rd. And we're gonna have our first big rally next week, Sabbath afternoon at 4 o'clock p.m. I'm asking all our Agape brethren to come out in numbers. We're going to wear our gold t-shirts And those of you who do not have your gold t-shirts, you can wear your green anniversary t-shirts. We're going to come out there and we're going to let the other churches know what Agape is doing in preparation for our evangelistic crusade by Dr. Henry Peters next year. So please, next week, Sunday at 4 o'clock p.m. We have our church board meeting. Our monthly church board meeting will be held this Tuesday via Zoom at 7 o'clock p.m. We have quite a few birthday celebrants during the month of December, but it's beginning a little. We have just one person who's celebrating birthday this upcoming week. And we want to say happy birthday in advance to Brother Trevor Fleming. He's going to be making birthday on the 8th of December. So, Brother Fleming, your Agape Church family sends their love when the time comes. Oh, yes, we have Sister Abednego. She will be 91 on the watch. Is that Sister Abednego? What date? On the 4th? The 4th? Monday coming, Sister Abednego will be 91. To God be the glory. And this is our thought for today. If we keep uppermost in our minds the unkind and unjust acts of others, we shall find it impossible to love them as Christ has loved us. But if our thoughts dwell upon the wondrous love and pity of Christ for us, the same spirit will flow out to others. We should love and respect one another, notwithstanding the faults and imperfections that we cannot help seeing. Humility and self-distrust should be cultivated. And a patient tenderness with the faults of others. This will kill out all narrowing selfishness and make us large-hearted and generous. Thank God.
Good morning, everyone. I'm sure someone has been assigned to welcome the Seventh-day Adventist, St. Thomas, St. John, Seventh-day Adventist School to Agape. But it would be remiss of me not to say my own welcome. Amen? Because we are happy to have them here with us today. And they have consented not only to be here and to advertise themselves, but to lift up the name of Jesus here at Agape. Amen? The Church of Body Love. So let me, on behalf of myself and indeed the entire Agape Church, welcome our school here today. We're going to be having at this time Elder Fleming, the second reading of our report. I'm going to ask that you come forward and do that now. So all church members, please take note, we're having our final reading of the report of the nominating committee at this time.
Morning, Saints. We're going to do our final reading today, and then we have a vote on it so that we can start making preparations for 2024, all right? And I'm calling the secretary to read the names, and then we'll proceed from there.
Adventist Youth, Head, Connie Jacobs. Team, Will Assistance, Jeffrey Fleming Jr., Isaiah Israel, Zion Baptist, Shanique Lewis, Ann King, Simone Ray, Mylon Frett, Kevin Matthew. Secretary, Willa Marie Baptist. Auditor, Baricia Baptist. Building Committee, Head, Alvinas Charles Sr., Team, Marva Mercer, Ermin Willie, Carl Malone, Delvin Mercer, Leon Monsanto, George Rogers, Milena Rogers Sr., Ashley Rogers. Children's Ministry, Head, Clara Sones, Webster Sones. Church clerk, Hen Jennifer Springett. Assistant, Marva Mercer. Communications ministry, Hen Shanique Lewis. Assistant, Marva Mercer. Team, Kabisa Smith, Zion Baptist, Simone Ray. Community services, Head, Ann King. Assistants, Marva Mercer, Valerie Pullion. Secretary, Connie Jacobs. Deacons, Head, Kevin Matthews. Assistants, Raul Rivera, Leonard Amy. Team, Zion Baptist, Carl Malone, Kevin Morton, Anthony Walter, Lauren Penn Jr., Studley Hughes, Mylon Frett, Earl Jeremiah, Edmund Penn, Alfonso Rogers, Milena Rogers Sr., Uzziah Israel. Deaconesses, Head, Sonia Santana. Assistant, Patricia Buchanan. Team, Ermin Francis Willie, Ermin Willie, Willa Marie Baptist, Olivia Carwood, Denise Daly, Valerie Pullion, Janelle James, Ann King, Maureen Myers, Lucita Lewis, Hyacinth Penn, Jacqueline Rogers, Linda Scotland, Uella Walter. Education Secretary, Head Dale Charles. Assistants, Barisia Baptist, Samuel Ray. Elders, First Elder, Jeffrey Royden Fleming. Second Elder, Elric Ford. Other Elders, Abigail Alphonse, Wilbert Baptist Jr., Delvin Mercer, Ashley Rogers, Kenneth Shelterbrandt, Kenneth Small, Samuel Ray. Family Life, Head, Jennifer Springett. Assistants, Vera Fleming, Ursula Victorine. Health Ministry, Head, Vera Fleming. Assistants, Abigail Alphonse, Dr. Arlene Christopher, Ursula Victorine, Lucita Lewis. Hospitality Ministry, Head, Marva Mercer. Assistants, Petra Bertrand, Patricia Buchanan, Ermin Willie. Princess Perez. Media Ministry, Head, Daniel Perez. Assistants, Mylon Frett, Hannah Joseph. Team, Willa Marie Baptist, Zion Baptist, Uzziah Israel. Men's Ministry, Head, Leon Monsanto. Assistants, Samuel Ray, Elric Foy. Team, Kenneth Shelterbrandt, Kevin Matthew, Patrick Hector Sr. Music Ministry, Head, Simone Ray. Team, Joel Webster, Patricia Buchanan. Pianist, Head, Simone Ray. Personal Ministries, Head, Elric Foy. Assistant, Ashley Rogers. Personal Ministries Secretary, Ann King. Prayer Ministry, Head, Wenceslas Smith. Assistant, Abigail Alphonse, Patricia Buchanan, Sandra Ray. Sabbath School Department, General Sabbath School Superintendent, Marva Mercer. Sabbath School Superintendents, Head, Petra Bertrand. Team, Willa Marie Baptist, Ursula Victorine, Janelle James, Shanique Lewis, Patricia Buchanan, Linda Scotland, Wenceslas Smith. Sabbath School Secretaries, Head, Bertil Smalls. Team, Connie Jacobs, Denise Daly, Willa Marie Baptist, Carol Rivera. Beginner Sabbath School, Head, Jennifer Springett. Kindergarten Sabbath School, Head, Jennifer Springett. Primary Sabbath School, Head, Cicelyn Brunn. Junior Early Teen Sabbath School, Head, Richard Ryan. Assistant, Wilbert Baptist Jr. Youth Sabbath School, Head, Kenneth Shelterbrandt. Stewardship, Head, Samuel Ray. Treasury Department, Assistants, Princess Perez, Jasmine Powell, George Rogers. Ushers, Head, Petra Bertrand. Assistant, Marva Mercer. Team, Patricia Buchanan, Joan Burton, Olivia Carwood, Ermin Willie, Jane Desire, Maureen Myers, Hyacinth Penn, Sonia Santana, Jacqueline Rogers, and Kabisa Smith. Women's Ministries, Head, Ermin Willie, Assistant, Kabisa Smith. Team, Jane Morton, Ursula Victorine, Juliana Lewis, Joelle Peterson, Patricia Buchanan. Adventurers, Head, Joel Webster, Assistant, Patricia Buchanan. Pathfinders, Head, Claire Webster Soans, Assistant, Vera Fleming. Investment, Head, Winceslas Smith. Team, Petra Bertrand, Jacqueline Rogers, Leonard Amy, Edmund Penn. Possibilities, Head, Makisha Regis. Assistant, Linda Scotland. Religious Liberty, Head, Kenneth Shelterbrand. Publishing, Head, Elric Foy. Interest Coordinator, Head, Dale Charles. Here ends the reading of the 2024-2025 Church Officers. Church Board Members, All Elders, Head Deacon, Head Deaconess, Treasurer, Church Clerk, Community Services Ministry Head, Men's Ministry Head, Personal Ministry Head, Sabbath School General Superintendent, Prayer Ministry Head, AY Leader, Pathfinder Leader, Adventurer Leader, Children's Ministry Head, Music Ministry Head, Communication Ministry Head, Education Secretary Head, Family Life Ministry Head, Health Ministry Head, Stewardship Ministry Head, Women's Ministry Head, Media Ministry Head, Building Committee Head, Possibilities Head, Interest Coordinator, Religious Liberty Head.
Thank you, Mr. Shanique. All right, folks, you've heard the names read? Oh, yes, for the second time. Because we had them read 2 weeks ago, they were posted back there. We had a few changes, and now we're ready for the vote. Can I have a motion that we accept the names as read as officers for 2024 and 2025? It's moved, is there a second? Second? All those in favor that we accept these names as read as the officers for 2024-2025, may I see uplifted right hand, please. Thank you. Those opposed, same sign. Thank you, it's carried. Members of the nominating committee, here endeth our work, all right?
I want to, on behalf of the church, say thanks very much to Elder Fleming, who, because of his vast experience, continue to be called upon to play these vital roles for our church, and continue to do so, not murmuring or complaining. So, Elder Fleming, we want to thank you and the members of the nominating committee. Just to let you know, during the year, while there are offices to be filled, the church board will always take on that responsibility, and there's still one or two minor adjustments to be made, or additions, I should say, to the report, but the church board is the body that will look into that, the report having been accepted. Just to mention, tonight, this evening, there will be a meeting of the Coordinating Council Project Committee. I'm mentioning it because it will be happening here at the church. Pastor Peters, who is the coordinator for the island, will be here, and he'll be having that meeting here. This afternoon, I will be in St. John, be having a business meeting over in St. John, so I may not be back, but I'm just letting, Elder Fleming knows, and Brother his son will be here to make sure that the building is open and that that meeting can convene. Of course, tomorrow we have coordinating council itself at the City Seventh-day Adventist Church. We're having, of course, our Bible class. It continues tomorrow evening. Do I have a witness in the house? Well, of course, as we say, nothing stops our Bible class, isn't that so? So we will have our Bible class tomorrow evening, and I invite you. And we want to intensify our attendance, especially because we have the crusade that is upcoming. Make sure that all our friends and well-wishers attend our Bible class, 6:30 on Sunday evening. Please keep that announcement in mind, and may God bless us as we worship him today in the beauty of holiness with our school. Amen.
Huh? Good morning. Good morning. Good morning and happy Sabbath. What a joy it is to be in the presence and in the house of God. Amen. God has been good to us throughout the week, and we want to give him thanks and praise. Welcome to Agape, the most southeastern Seventh-day Adventist Church in St. Thomas. We welcome you who are worshiping in the sanctuary and those who have joined on media platforms. A special welcome is extended to the faculty, staff, and students of the St. Thomas St. John Seventh-day Adventist School who are worshiping with us today. We pray that your worship experience today be spirit-filled and a source of strength as you walk with the Lord. Welcome.
Amen. And she did all of that without a paper. Hallelujah. Good job, Siva. Amen. Happy Sabbath, Agape. All right. Greetings from the St. Thomas St. John Seventh Adventist School. We're here to worship with you this morning, and we're happy to be here, and we hope that you will be blessed. We are 147 student bodies strong. Amen? Amen? We have a faculty and staff of 35, which also includes our volunteers and monitors. At this time, I would like to ask all of our teachers and staff and faculty, all our workers, to please stand. All of our staff members, to please stand. Amen. 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 And I would like to introduce everyone to our new business manager, Mrs. Amelia Mitchell. Amen. Amen. At this time, I'd like for all of our students to stand. All of our students on the platform and in the audience. Amen. Remain standing. I'd like the parents to please stand. Parents, please stand. Amen. 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 You may be seated. Parents, thank you for entrusting entrusting your children to us. At our school, we are committed to teaching the students to make them competent students, preparing them academically, and also helping them to develop good characters. We offer a well-rounded education, thus offering classes, lessons, and clubs in the areas of standard academics, leadership, entrepreneurship, STEM, robotics, art, agriculture, music, crochet, physical education, and fitness. We continue to take advantage of opportunities provided to us, which includes preparations in disaster preparedness, field trips, college fairs and presentations from various guests of various topics, participation in various competitions. We just ended competing in cross country, and your member, Zion Baptist, did very well in the competition. Amen. Amen. And we participate in so much more. We continue to take advantage of community service opportunities, and thus this Thanksgiving, our students contributed and we prepared lovely Thanksgiving baskets for our seniors in the church and in the community. They were so happy to receive these from the students. Our goal is to prepare our wonderful students to be competent citizens here in this world, but more so, to be ready citizens for the kingdom of God. We solicit your continued prayers and support so that we can continue to do what God requires of us at his school. And I say amen. Amen. Again, thank you for allowing us to be here. I would like, please, along with the Education Secretary, to meet with all parents of school-aged children who currently do not attend our school. If you can meet me at the end of the service on this side of the church, okay? Thank you again, and happy Sabbath.
Stand for call to worship.
We set our work aside. We leave our cares behind on this day of Sabbath rest. On this your holy day, we come to give you praise. On this day of Sabbath rest, Sabbath rest, holy rest, on the day he set aside, hallowed, blessed, and sanctified, Sabbath rest. On this day of Sabbath rest.
Come, oh come, let us worship and bow down. Let us kneel before the Lord our Maker, for he is God, and we are the people of his pasture and the sheep of his hand. This is called to worship.
Sim.
Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for this day. Thank you for letting us all reach here safely, and please continue to keep us safe. Please keep us under your wings. Provide us with divine protection, love, safety, mercy, and grace. And please let us enjoy today's worship service. Amen.
You may be seated.
Okay, good morning, church. Good morning, church. We're quiet today. I hope we've come to give God praise because he has done so many wonderful things for us. Can you say amen for that? Yes, he has. And so this morning, we want to see Jesus. How many of you want to see Jesus when he comes again? I do. And as we are here on earth, we want to worship him. We want to be in his presence so that we can experience him here as well. So our first song this morning is going to be Open the Eyes of My Heart, Lord, because I want to see you. I want to see Jesus. So let's sing.
Open the eyes of my heart, I want to see you, I want to see you. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord, open the eyes of my heart, I want to see you, I want to see you. To see you high and lifted up, shining in the light of your glory. Open the eyes of my heart, I want to see you, I want to see you. To see you high and lifted up, shining in the light of your glory. Pour out your power and love as we sing holy, holy, holy. High and lifted up, shining in the light of your glory. Pour out your power and love as we sing holy, holy, holy. Holy, holy, holy. Holy, holy, holy. I want to see you. I want to see you. Holiness, holiness is what I long for. Holiness is what I need.
Holiness is what I need.
That's what I need. Holiness, holiness is what you want from me. Ooh. Righteousness, righteousness is what I long for. Righteousness is what I need. Righteousness, righteousness is what you want from me. Take my heart. brokenness. Brokenness is what I long for. Brokenness is what I need. Brokenness, brokenness is what you want for me. Take my heart and mold it. Take my mind, transform it. Take my will, conform it to yours, to yours, oh Lord.
So that I may worship. 185. Jesus is all the world to me, number 185.
Our hymn of praise is number 185. Jesus is all the world to me, number 185.
Please bow your head for prayer. Dear Lord, thank you for this day, for we are in your church. I pray that we will have another day and a wonderful day tomorrow. In Jesus' name, amen. Please sit. The deacon. The deacons will now wait to collect our tithes, offerings, and gifts.
Jahiel and his friend Joseph live in the beautiful country of Belize in Central America. They never get bored with so many exciting places to explore. They may swim with fish in the ocean, walk through the jungle to spot animals, or even stumble upon an ancient carved stone left by people who lived in the area hundreds of years ago. Jahiel and Joseph also attend the Adventist school in southern Belize, where they play with their friends during recess. The boys love playing marbles, while the girls jump rope. They study various subjects like math, English, Spanish, history, and Bible. Sometimes, the teacher asks Jahiel to present a short sermon to the other students during worship. When it happens, he always asks Joseph to sing for the class. Jahiel gets a little nervous when it is time to speak in front of a group, but he knows God will help him. As soon as the teacher introduces Jahiel and Joseph to the class, Jahiel no longer feels nervous. Sometimes at the end, the other kids ask him questions about the stories he shares. The pastor at his church also invited Jahiel to preach there too. Of course, Joseph will be there to sing alongside him. Jahiel dreams of becoming a pastor someday, but he knows he has to finish school first. Numerous stories similar to Jahiel's are unfolding worldwide within the network of over 9,000 Adventist schools. Among the 2 million plus students currently enrolled, thousands are being equipped to assume roles as missionaries, such as pastors, teachers, nurses, or physicians. This symbiotic relationship between strong Adventist education and a robust Adventist church is evident. The 111,360 educators within Adventist educational institutions are expected to seamlessly blend faith with instruction, and between 2009 and 2018, this integration resulted in 463,000 people baptized at Adventist educational institutions. Adventist schools are important missionary agencies. According to an interesting study, a young person who does not attend an Adventist school is 13 times less likely to join the church. And while among many demographic groups, around 50% leave the church by their mid-20s, the Value Genesis study revealed that the more years in Adventist education, the greater belief in the fundamental beliefs of the church, and the more likely they are to remain Seventh-day Adventist at age 40. We can also help support this work by returning our tithes and promise, regular and systematic offerings. If distributed as suggested by the combined offering plan, part of your promise offering goes towards building and maintaining mission schools in over 100 countries. By regularly worshiping God with a percentage of our income as an offering, and distributing that offer as suggested by the combined offering plan, we can make a difference for eternity in the lives of children and adults worldwide. May we put our desires last and God first.
Hello, boys and girls. This is Aunt Fernita, and I have a wonderful story for you called Shipwrecked. Today's memory verse is from 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 11. It says, "Encourage one another and build each other up." The message for today's story is we serve others when we encourage them. Have you ever been on a boat? Was the water calm or choppy? Paul and his friends were on a boat in a really bad storm, and something terrible happened. The wind howled and screamed. The rain poured down. Waves pounded against the ship, and the ship rocked and tipped dangerously. All the people on board were certain that the boat would sink and they would all drown. All but Paul, that is. Paul stood before the people. Last night, my God sent an angel to me, he shouted over the storm. Do not be afraid, the angel said. God will save you and all the people sailing with you. I trust in God, Paul declared. Everything will happen as his angel told me, but we will crash on an island. After 2 weeks, the sailors sensed that the ship was near land. They threw their anchors overboard, hoping that they would keep the ship from running into the rocky shore. As everyone waited anxiously for daylight, Paul said, "You have not eaten in all these days. Please eat something. You will need your strength. And remember, we will all be saved." Then Paul began to eat, so everyone else ate too, and they felt better. When daylight finally came, the sailors tried to steer the ship towards the shore, but it ran into the ground and got stuck. Then huge pounding waves broke the boat apart. Some people swam to shore. Others clung to pieces of wood that had broken off the boat and paddled towards the beach. All 276 people from the ship reached the shore safely. Many of the friendly people who lived on the island built big fires on the beach to warm the survivors. While Paul helped gather wood for the fire, a poisonous snake called a viper bit his arm. Paul quickly shook his arm and the snake fell into the fire. The people were so sure that Paul was going to die, but nothing happened. God was taking care of him. Publius, the chief ruler of the island, invited Paul and some others to his house and cared for their needs. During the 3 days that Paul stayed there, he learned that Publius's father was very sick. So Paul laid hands on him and asked God to heal him, and Publius's father was healed. The news of the healing spread quickly around the island, and people brought their sick to Paul. Paul prayed for each sick person, and the Lord healed every one of them. The friendly people who lived on the island of Malta blessed the shipwrecked travelers by caring for them, and God blessed the people of Malta who were really serving him when they showed kindness to the travelers. We can show kindness to others too. We can serve God every day by helping people in need and by praying for them. God will bless us too.
This podcast was brought to you by gracelink.net and Studio El Piso. For more children's resources, please visit gracelink.net.
Happy Sabbath, everyone. It's good to be back. It's been a long 6 years. I'm glad to see so many familiar faces. Be blessed by the song that I sing.
Judah was paralyzed by fear when they heard a mighty multitude was quickly drawing near. But as they prayed for deliverance, the victory would begin. For when we call upon the Lord, we summon all of heaven. Pray on, for you are who the Lord is looking for. Pray on, for this will tear those mighty strongholds down. Stay on your knees, for this is where the battle is won. Very soon you'll win the victory. Pray on. When Daniel faced the lions for worshiping the Lord, it seemed there was no hope at all for what would be in store. For when we stand on holy ground, our smallest prayer is heard. Instead of on our circumstance, our eyes are on the Lord. Pray on, for you are who the Lord is looking for. Pray on, for this will tear those mighty strongholds down. Stay on your knees, for this is where the battle is won. Very soon you'll win the victory. Pray on. When your questions go unanswered and your prayers may seem in vain, they don't seem to make a difference, they don't seem to make a change, just rest assured God knows your needs and he hears each time you pray. Your prayers are reaching heaven, and the answer's on the way. Pray on, for you are who the Lord is looking for. Pray on, tear those mighty strongholds down. Stay on your knees, for this is where the battle is. There's no better place for you to be than seeking the Father prayerfully. Very soon you'll win the victory. Pray on. Pray.
As far as possible, let us kneel for prayer. Gracious God in heaven, this morning we come to you. Lord, we come to you to worship and to give you praise, honor, and glory, because God, only you deserve. Lord, this morning as we worship you and as we pray to you, I stand in your presence on behalf of your waiting congregation. Lord, I ask you to remove from me anything that is unlike you, and that you will allow my prayers to reach your heavenly throne on behalf of your church. Oh God, this morning I bring your waiting congregation. As we wait upon what you have in store for us, I pray, Lord, that each one of us will receive something that will help us to be drawn closer to you today. Lord, I pray that you will be with every member, every visitor, and that you will continue to guide us and help us to look no place else but unto you. Lord, this morning among us, we have lots of sick and shut-in members. We pray, O God, for those who may be looking on. We ask that you will continue to be with them. Let your Holy Spirit continue to guide them and comfort them no matter the circumstances. We have those who still are not feeling good among us. And I ask, Lord, that you will be with each one of us no matter what ailment we may have. Help us to know that we have a God who is a healing balm in Gilead. Lord, help us to look to you no matter the circumstances, because you are able when none of us are. Lord, this morning, the Seventh-day Adventist school is worshiping in Agape. Lord, our school, that lighthouse up on that little hill, I ask, Lord, that you will continue to be with them. I pray that you will surround them with hedges of protection with your holy angels. God, we are living in a time when our identity is questioned. I pray, oh God, that you will help each boy, each girl, that way they will not be confused as to who they are and whom they belong to. I pray that you will continue to be the guide in the school so that we will recognize you in each boy and each girl. I pray, Lord, that you will give our teachers, empower them, Lord, from on high, so that what you give is what's going to be coming out to our students. I pray, Lord, as they feed our students with your word daily, I pray, oh God, that our students will continue to be a lighthouse in our community. Lord, you say, train up a child in the way in which he should go, and when he is old, he will not depart from it. Lord, what an awesome mission story we had this morning. Even such a little child can testify of your goodness and of your love. And we praise you, Lord, for what you are doing with our children. Lord, this morning I bring our parents before you. And even those who do not have their children in the school. Father God, this is a testimony. This is a testament. It's an investment. Lord, help us all to be willing to participate one with another, to be able to get our boys surrounded in every aspect with you. Lord, when they're at home, when they're at school, when they're at church, I pray, Lord, that if it's fear in our parents' heart, that you will remove that fear, Lord. You removed that fear from me years ago, and I made it, and I'm so grateful. And Lord, I could leave today to testify of your goodness towards the investment that we have made in our children. Lord, help parents to recognize you, that when they do for you, that you will stand tall for them, no matter the circumstances. Maybe there are days they may not even have extra food, but spaghetti and meat sauce is okay. Help them to realize that too. A bag of flour can go a very long way, Lord. Help them to recognize that too. But Lord, help them to recognize that we are in perilous times. Perilous times where our boys and girls need nothing but you. Lord, help us so that we will all be living examples to our children day by day. Into your hands now I commit the speaker, Brother Zion. Lord, I pray that you will be with him, and whatever he is going to give us today, whatever you gave him to give us today, I pray that we will all feed on it and continue to live like you. I pray that you will take away any distraction from him so that his word will come forth clear, so that we will all understand, even to the smallest of child. So Lord, I just want to thank you today for this beautiful day that you have given us, so that we can worship you in spirit and in truth. Continue to be with each boy, each girl, and as the choir prepares to come forward, I pray, oh God, that you will be with them. Let the message also be one that we will be able to use and magnify everything that goes on to the end of the service. Continue to keep us and guide us all, we pray, in Jesus' holy name. Amen.
Good afternoon, church. Our scripture reading is taken from Deuteronomy chapter 6, 1 to 2, chapter 5 to 7, and Proverbs 22, verse 6. I will read in your hearing. Now, this is the greatest commandment, and these are the statutes and judgments which the Lord your God has commanded to teach you, that you may observe them in the land which you are crossing over to possess, that you may fear the Lord your God to keep all his statutes and his commandments, and which I command you, you and your son and your grandson, all the days of your life, and the days may be prolonged. Chapter 5 says, verse 5 says, you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your strength. And these words which I command you today shall be in your heart. You shall teach them diligently to your children, and you shall talk of them when you sit in your house, when you walk by the way, when you lie down, and when you rise up. Proverbs 22,
Proverbs 22, verse 6 says, train up a child in the way he should go, and when he is old, he will not depart from it. This is the word of the Lord.
And Baricia Baptist, and brother to three sisters. He is very energetic and passionate. He loves learning about animals, particularly their behavioral traits. He is the former president of the student council at our school. He has participated in the inter-school cross-country races for the past 3 years. He has also participated in the moot court competition and is a member of the school choir. When our speaker was dedicated to the Lord in this church 17 years ago, the pastor commented that he has a preacher's name. Well, he's not a preacher, but the next voice you'll hear after a special item of music from our choir is that of my brother, Zion Baptist.
Thank you.
Hello, church. I'd like to thank the choir, Ms. Tull, Mr. Jeconias, and the rest of the band team for special music. My topic today is building characters for eternity. Before I get into it, though, I'd like to tell you a story. Once upon a time, in the land of parenting, there lived two builders. Both had been given the responsibility to construct a building, the counsel to start early, the guidelines from the master designer, the hotline number where to reach the master designer, along with the instruction to stay in touch, and both had been given the necessary tools to accomplish the task. The first builder knew the responsibility was his, and he knew the counsel. However, when he began reading the guidelines, that was a completely different story. He reasoned, "These instructions are too general. It is so difficult to relate all these old-time guidelines to today's modern world. Lifestyles today are so different, and the more detailed plans seemed too unrealistic. It is impossible for me to build like this because of the kind of world I live in and because it has so many pressing responsibilities. Truthfully, I want to know all the specifics. I need to know exactly how hard and how many times I have to pound on the nail to make it go in the right way. These plans just don't cut it. I really don't have the time to call the master designer all the time. What will he think if I keep on bothering him all the time with such little things?" So he went on his own and built a little here and a little there. He built whenever he could fit time into his schedule. His building grew, yes, but it easily toppled in the storm. Now let's take a look at the second builder. He took his responsibility to build far more seriously. To understand clearly the master designer's counsel, he read the guidelines from cover to cover. He selected those principles that he could use to develop his own set of plans to meet his specific needs. He studied the designs and developed by other successful builders, but rather than follow them blindly, he searched for the architectural principles that would apply to his unique situation. What a job! It would have been so much easier to follow blindly what others had done before. But in the guidelines of the master designer, he found this challenge from Deuteronomy 1:21. "See, the Lord your God has given you the land. Go up and take possession of it. Build on it, as the Lord, the God of your fathers, has told you. Do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged." These words energized the builder. So he took courage, picked up his tools, and began to build. He kept in constant contact with the master designer. He wasn't afraid to admit his lack of knowledge and to ask for help. He was thankful for the hotline. He didn't do a perfect job, especially in the early days, when he was new to the task. It takes time to learn. He pounded in a few bent nails. He even papered the wrong wall a time or two. But when this happened, he said, "I'm sorry," and started again. Rather than hide his mistakes, he corrected them as soon as he became aware of them. Even though it took a little more time and patience, the results were worth it, for his building was nearly perfect. After 18 years of planning, pounding, and papering, the building, although not fully complete, was ready to stand on its own. And it did, through the wind and the storm. When people came to the house warming, they all liked it from the inside out. And the master designer said, "Well done, good and faithful servant. You have been faithful with a few things. I will put you in charge of many things. Come and share your master's happiness." And he did. Parents, which one of these builders are you? I understand your dilemma. The world in which we live has gone mad. There are so many voices calling. These voices are calling out to us, your children, in a special way, and we need to know who to follow. Our spiritual life is at stake. You need to help us shape our spiritual character. Look at us. We are like Plato. Someone or something is going to mold us. will it be you, Christian parents, or the world? Your biggest job is the first 7 years of our lives. Are you aware that the childhood period is a critical period for a person's character to be formed and shaped? Author K. Kuzma stresses that, in fact, during the first 7 years of the foundation, the 7 years of a child's foundation, the character is pretty much established. What advice can I give you as you work in building our characters for eternity? Here goes. Number one, you must have a plan for building our characters. What do you want to build in our lives? Visualize us as God does, at the height of maturity. Do you see us walking with God, sharing time and possessions with others, ministering to those in need, being self-sacrificing, or serving God on the mission field? When you keep such pictures in mind, you will keep on target and focus on ideas for parenting that will likely... increase the likelihood for these values and goals to be accepted and incorporated in our lives. Number two, you must teach by precept. Make the most of opportunities and activities in which we are interested in to teach us important values and beliefs such as love, respect, honesty, and kindness. Teach continuously and with perseverance. Formation of habits and the training of character are not attained by isolated efforts, but by regular and unceasing repetition. Look for teachable moments. Don't let opportunities slip by because you are too tired at the end of the day, or because you think we are too busy playing, or everyone is glued to their devices. Teach us according to Deuteronomy 6:7, when you sit at home, and when you walk along the road, when you lie down, and when you get up. This means use every opportunity you get. Number three, teach by example. There is an old saying, actions speak louder than words. And another one says, example set, example follows. Parents, we will have greater respect for instruction if we witness a genuineness in the models of our mothers and fathers. If you want us to be kind, you must first show kindness. If you want us to love God and revere His Sabbath, you must show us how to love the Lord and keep His day holy. Number four, discover our personality. When the Bible says, train a child in the way he should go, and when he is old, he will not turn from it, Proverbs 6:20, what do you think that means? It means that you have to recognize the individual differences in us, your children. You must train us in keeping with our individual talents or bent. Discover what our bent is and train us accordingly. Don't try to fit us all in your mold. Be wise and sensitive to the way God has made each of us, so you can cultivate and bring forth the best in us. Observe, listen, and spend time with each of us to discover our interests, strengths, and weaknesses. Help us become what God has intended for us to be. Read Proverbs 20:11-12, and it answers as it is the best answer. Number five, teach us to think. While it is important to teach us by precept and example, it is even more important to teach us to think for ourselves. Teach us how to think morally and clear up our religious values so we can clarify our own and see the consequences of our actions. Don't just tell us what we may or may not do. Train us to understand why. Help us love Jesus for ourselves as we think about an action and why it is right or wrong. Pose dilemmas to us and ask us, what would we do and why? For example, you might ask, what would you do if your family didn't have enough food and the neighbors had plenty but wouldn't give you any? Help us think about and find justifications for our reactions. Number six, help us to develop self-control. Don't try to shield us from the consequences of our decisions. If we decide to act on certain issues after considering your advice, allow us to make that choice. When we make a wrong choice, we may have to pay for it, but the experience can teach us valuable lessons. Don't try to do everything for us or we will never learn and develop self-control or consider what is right from wrong. Lessons learned from previous experiences will sharpen our insight and help us to have confidence that we are making good choices. Finally, number 7, help us develop a sense of responsibility. Give us responsibility so we can understand how to act morally and reason morally. Responsibilities can include doing our homework, keeping our commitments, and taking care of possessions. It also means giving us responsibilities to take care for others, like supervising or reading to a younger sibling or a family member, sharing household chores, or putting aside pocket money for a worthy cause. Start from our early age to teach us principles of stewardship, including how to return our tithes and give an offering to God's cause. Responsibility training should start early. Teach us even from 2 years old how to wash dishes and fold towels. Yes, we will make a mess, drive you crazy. We will keep you back and seem to give you even more work. But think of how well you are preparing us for future usefulness. To train us to have upright characters, to love God, and to be loyal citizens now and in the future, and to have genuine concerns for the welfare of others, requires a life of self-sacrifice on your part. Parents, we appreciate you. We know that all your training is a labor of love and patience. The effort you put into us will be richly rewarded by the Master Builder. As we conclude, parents, keep in mind that He is still working on you and on us. Thank you.
Thank you, Zion, for that sermon. Our hymn of consecration is hymn number 186, I Found a Friend, hymn number 186.
From him who loveth me so well, what part my
Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for the service we had today. Thank you for loving us, guiding us, and protecting us. As we leave your house, please bless us and bring us home safely. Direct us and reveal more of your love to us daily. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.